Form Army Chief Sarath Fonseca was for the first time produced before a civilian court Wednesday and accused of inciting violence, the AFP news agency reported. Fonseca, who is under military custody and faces separate court-martial charges of engaging in politics while in uniform and corrupt procurements, was brought before a magistrate over his reported comments against the president's brother. Police investigators told the court that Fonseca had alleged in a newspaper interview that the president's younger brother and defense secretary Gotabe Rajapaksa had ordered the killing of surrendering Tamil Tiger rebels. Fonseca later said that the newspaper had misquoted him and that no such incident took place during the final days of the battle. Environmentalists warn that the separation and decentralization of the environment portfolio to sub-ministries will ultimately dampen the powers to safeguard the environment. According to the Extraordinary Gazette issued by the government last month, the Department of Wildlife Conservation is gazetted under the Ministry of Economic Development, while Department of Coast Conservation has come under the Ministry of Ports and Aviation.
පරිසර අමාත්‍යාංශයට නෙවෙයි ඒ ප්‍රතිපත්ති තීරණ ක්‍රියාත්මක කරන වනජීවි සංරක්ෂණ දෙපාර්තමේන්තුව බාර දීලා තියෙන්නේ. ඒක තමයි මෙතන තියෙන පළවෙනි නොපෑහීම. දෙවෙනි නොපෑහීම තමයි ආර්ථික සංවර්ධනය කියන එක වනජීවි සංරක්ෂණයත් එක්ක පනතේ පූර්විකාවෙම ගැටෙනවා. මොකද පූර්විකාවම කියනවා වනජීවි සංරක්ෂණය කියන එකේදී වනජීවීන් ආර්ථික වශයෙන් පරිහරණය කිරීම නැවැත්වීම පනතේ යුතුකමක් කියලා. එතකොට මේ පරිපාලනය කර යුතු ආයතනයයි මේක සංවර්ධනය කළ යුතු ආයතනයි එකම අමාත්‍යංශයක් ඇත්තේ තිබුණාම මෙතන බලවත් විසංවාදයක් තියෙනවා. මොකද එතකොට අමාත්‍යංශයේ ප්‍රතිපත්ති තීරණය බර වෙන්නේ මේක පාවිච්චි කිරීමටද මේක පාලනය කිරීමටද කියන එක පිළිබඳ ගැටලුවට.
A special train and bus service between Colombo and the Bandaranaike International Airport is set to start in the near future, the government said in a statement. The project will be carried out by the Transport Ministry in collaboration with the Ports and Aviation Ministry. The Goldface Green will be closed for the public from today till 20th May in view of the Victory Day celebrations, the police issuing a statement said. The Board of Investment is processing almost $500 million of new deals mainly into leisure and is planning two investment zones in the former war-torn north of the island, officials said. BOI Director AMC Kulasekara said there was strong interest in leisure and business process outsourcing. The agency was processing or had already approved about $480 million in new applications mainly to the leisure sector. The investments will be realized over several years as hotels are built.
We have nearly tourism sector includes certain other ICT and services sector. We go as one sector. We'll have about nearly 55,000 millions. 55,000
billion rupees. Eh?
Yes, rupees.
Equal.
Yes, right.
55,000 billion rupees.
Yeah.
Processing in.
That is already we have approved these projects up to March, end of March.
So about $500 million.
That's right. This is a new application. Yeah. New ones, not the ongoing ones.
Kulasekara said the end of the war had opened up 2/3 of the country's beach areas for tourism and 1/3 of land for agriculture for anyone to invest and develop. The agency was planning to open two investment zones in Mankulam and Kilinochi in the northern province. Kilinochi was once a key stronghold of the defeated Tamil Tiger separatists. Farming, fishing and construction activity is peaking in the former war-torn north and eastern areas, and Sri Lanka's diaspora was starting to invest, especially in small hotels and guest houses in Jaffna at the northern tip of the island.
The organized private sector of the country have been overjoyed that the principal obstacles to economic development, i.e. the curse of terrorism and the political instability, have now been removed. They have pledged to support the economic development plans of the country, which once achieved, will greatly enhance and improve prospects for them and improve their businesses, and this will benefit the whole corporate sector of the country.
Indian Film Academy Weekend.
The International Indian Film Academy announced the nominations for the IFA Awards 2010, which is to be held in Sri Lanka next month. Successful Indian films Three Idiots, Wanted, Kamine, Pa and Dev D in the previous year are vying for the title of Best Picture. The actors nominated this year for performance in a leading role male are Amir Khan for Three Idiots, Amitabh Bachchan for Pa, Saif Ali Khan for Love Aajkal, Salman Khan for Wanted, Shahid Kapoor for Kamine and Ranbir Kapoor for Wake Up Sid. The winner for performance in a leading role female will be chosen among Kareena Kapoor for Three Idiots, Priyanka Chopra for Kamine, Deepika Padukone for Love Aajkal, Vidya Balan for Pa and Mahe Gill for Dev D. The Met Department says thunder showers will develop inland during the afternoon or evening and will spread to the southwestern coastal areas later. A few showers will also occur along the western coastal areas in the morning. There may be temporarily localized fairly strong winds during thunder showers. The public is requested to take precautions to minimize damages caused by lightning. You can now follow Debrief on YouTube, Twitter and Facebook.